Hi dear e-learners, another important lecture about technical writing. In this lecture, we'll cover very important ideas under the heading Approaching a Writing Project. We'll discuss mindset and different approaches for writing better technical documents. So number one, establishing the mindset. The thought of preparing a piece of scientific writing can intimidate everybody, even the best writers. Anyhow, establishing a suitable mindset and taking appropriate steps certainly make this huge task manageable. Remember that we are trying to write technical reports for communication, not to impress others. So in this aspect, we go further that readers of scientific publications want to know what you have done, what you have found, and basically what are its implications. So fundamentally, people are not seeking great literary merit in your reporting. So what is important? One should do good research, and secondly, present it clearly. You will please and satisfy your audience. In scientific writing, readers should notice mainly the content, not the style. So it doesn't mean that we should not bother about style, but okay, fundamentally, content is the king. Oh, and this is true in every domain. Okay, we move further. Realize that those reading your work want you to do well. These people often make constructive criticisms. Your supervisors, your teachers, your peers, your class fellows, they do so because they want your work to succeed. This is very important. It is very important realization. So do not be paralyzed by the prospect of criticism. Feel fortunate that you will receive feedback that can help your writing to be at its best. So this is true for every genre of writing. Okay, preparing to write. In the lab, careful preparation helps experiments proceed smoothly and efficiently. Okay, very important assertion. Much is the same for scientific writing. It is also true for scientific writing. Another important assertion, good writing is largely a matter of effective imitation. So we should read good papers and try to imitate the style of those good authors. We move further. Preparing to write, the second important idea after changing the mindset. While you are gathering scientific content, ideas for your paper may occur to you. Okay, then what should we do? Write down those ideas. Consider creating for each section of your paper a file, either on paper or electronic, in which to place them. So whatever pleases you, follow that process. Recording your ideas will keep them away from escaping your memory. This is very important. And having such ideas readily available to draw on afterwards can get your writing off to a quick start. So this is very useful, very important idea. We move further. Once you have gathered and analyzed data, speaking can become a fine transition to writing. If possible, present your work at your department. Similarly, try to give an oral or poster presentation at a conference. So preparing to speak can also help in formulating your article. Also, questions from listeners can help you to shape what you will write. Research typically is a team endeavor. To facilitate writing, do lots of pre-writing. For example, stack copies of published papers in the order in which you plan to cite them. So you should, rather I'll say, you must have all those papers in hard form which you want to cite. Okay, make outlines, list points you wish to make in a given section, and sort and resort them until you are pleased with the order. Make a formal outline. So this is a very important idea. In the upcoming lectures, we'll also focus on this idea in more detail. Okay, by doing much of the thinking and organization beforehand, you can lower the activation allergy needed to write a paper. Such pre-writing can catalyze the writing process so well that you will find yourself eager to write. In preparing to write, realize that sometimes ideas must percolate for a while. So this is very natural and very organic process. For example, you cannot come up with an effective way to begin your paper or to structure a section. Oh, it's a great challenge. So take a break, exercise for a while, take a nap, or maybe discuss your work with your support group. Obviously, a solution may then occur to you. Good writing tends to be largely a matter of good revising. So revising your work is now our main topic. No one will see your early drafts and no one cares how rough they are. So it's really a comforting thought for all the writers. The important thing is to revise your writing until it works well. First, revise your writing yourself, then show it to others, your support system, and using their feedback, revise your writing more. Revision is not just for beginners, for students. Researchers with long success in publishing revise their papers. So just a very short anecdote. After a presentation to a scientific writing class, a famous scientist and journal editor was asked this question: do you revise your work? He replied, if I am lucky, only about 10 times. So this is a good example for all of us. In revising your work, ask yourself these questions. So these are very important questions, and they guide us to very important ideas. Okay, we move on. After receiving feedback from those reviewing your manuscript, consider how to apply it. This is very important. Follow those suggestions that you find useful. Even if a suggestion seems unsuitable, keep it in mind. Although you may disagree with it, it may alert you to a problem. For example, if a reader misinterpreted a point, you may try to state it more clearly. Comparing the various readers' comments may aid in this regard. If only one reader had difficulty with an item, you might dismiss it as a fluke. So chances are that people don't understand your ideas. So if multiple readers do so, improvement is certainly needed over there. So thank you, dear e-learners. I hope you will find these ideas very interesting and very useful. Thank you.